Hi children, welcome back again. Okay, so already we have discussed a lot many things in the previous video. In this video we are going to continue the next part of the last video. That is, in the second chapter we have discussed till these two points. We will continue in this video the next points. That is, as we know that there are different many types of plants on the every region on the land or on the earth. And where they have adapted themselves with their special features, that process is known as the adaptation. And then which are those reasons or which are those places, what we and then which what we call for those plants, we can divide those plants into like terrestrial plants, aquatic plants, marshy area, that is mangroves, and then we can especially we have three types: terrestrial, aquatic and mangroves. Depending upon the area where the trees are going to grow or plants are going to grow, depending upon that we have categorized like this. Terrestrial means it is on the normal land, on the ice land or snowfall region, even in the coastal region. So like this, there may be the difference between the climate of the land. See, whatever climate we have here, the same climate is not there in the Dharwad, and the same climate is not there in the Bangalore, and the same climate is not there in the Jammu and Kashmir, and the same climate is not there in the Delhi. If you go to another country, the climate we have in our country right now, there is a lot of difference in America and in the England, because of it depends upon the weather condition. But then also, if these plants are there even in every country, right? The plants are not only there in our India, they are there in the every country of this whole world. Then depending upon the nature of that climate, how do they have adjusted? In the terrestrial, we can learn many types again. As I told you, normal land, what we have here, what type of fruits and what type of vegetables we are getting, those plants have adapted themselves to this climate, and the plants, they have got the adaptation in their leaf, in their stem, where they are growing in the snowfall region. And the plants, they have adjusted their length of their plant and the structure of the leaf. For example, coconut tree. In the coastal area, it has to stand because it has very long and strong stem or trunk. And even it has lot many leaf, very long and pointed leaf, isn't it? And there will be very high speed of wind, and even there will be heavy rainfall also. To fall down the raindrop, it should not stagnate on that raindrop on the leaf for more time. It should fall down. Because of that, the coconut tree leaf has the waxy wax-like structure on them. They have the shining like structure. So whichever amount of sunlight or water they are getting, they will just reflect back. Then those climate is not at all going to affect those parts of that plant. So like this, the plants have adopted themselves in the terrestrial type of plants in the different region of the earth. Next we have aquatic plants, which grow in the water, under the water. Below the water, there will be root, stem, everything will be there. Some plants, lotus, lily, we can see leaf will be floating on the water and flower will be totally upside of the surface of the water, and stem and roots will be under the water till the ground. Then the stem, almost aquatic plant stem will be having like pipe. Inside the stem there will be air will be filled, so that it would help to for respiration of the plant like this. So next we have the mangroves. Mangroves means the area where always water will be there, the area where always water will be filled. Then there also we can get the some type of plants. Then those all plants we call them as a mangroves. You might have seen So in this reason, what happens after some growth, no, the roots, parts of the roots will start growing upside of the water level, because they need the air where inside the water, and always the water is filled in that land, there will be less amount of soil, so air will be very less. So what happens here, like this mangrove plants will start, the roots of these plants will start growing upside of the water level. So this is what the speciality of mangroves, and aquatic, the air filled tube like stem, and the leaf will be long, and even leaf will be broad, which can help to float on the water. Then next we have this third chapter, that is adaptation in the animals. So same, how do the habitat we call in the plants, same we call the habitat for the animals, where animals are naturally living. Then adaptation, as we can see many types of animals on this world or on this earth. So tiger is different, elephant is different, giraffe is different, small rat is different, rabbit is different, squirrel is different, ants are different. Then why do they are different? Because they want to, or they have to adapt themselves for their lifestyle or their habitat. This is called as the adaptation. Then how can we categorize the animals? Again, here also we have animals which can live on the terrestrial part. Terrestrial means on land. On land there are wild animals, domestic animals, and like snake is also there, small animal is also there, butterfly is also there, parrot is also there. Like this, some animals are living in the next aerial means animals or birds which live in the, most of the time they are going to spend in the air. For them we call as a aerial animals. And some animals are there like fish, shark, whale, dolphin, and some other water dog and starfish and water horse, like this many types of animals are there which we can get those animals under the water. They will live only under the water, for them we call as the aquatic animals. And some animals are there, they are going to live on the tree, monkey, owl, and squirrel. So like this, and the bats, like this animals are there, they are going to live on the tree. They will just jump, trees are just like houses for them. They will go for hunting the food, and they will get the food, eat, again come and sit on the trees. They will not come to anyone's house, or they will not go under the water, or they will not fly in the air, but they prefer trees for their shelter. So for them we call them as the arboreal animals. Then last we have some animals like frog, snake, and crocodile, turtle. There are some animals which are going to live on the land. Even for like terrestrial animals, they will live on the land also, and even under the water also. For these type of animals we call as the amphibians. Okay, so children, we have discussed from types of plants, terrestrial plants, aquatic plants, mangroves, okay, and even in the third lesson we have discussed about what is habitat in the animals, how we can define the habitat for the animals, or terrestrial for the, sorry, adaptation for the animals, and which type of, adaptation in animals, how we have divided into, five types again, that is terrestrial, aquatic, aerial, arboreal, and the amphibians. So this is what the brief revision of all three chapters we have done in these two videos. I hope you all have enjoyed this and understood this, and start solving next exercise, worksheet of this next pages that you have in your textbook. If you don't have textbook, try to purchase that one, and at least solve one or two pages. That is what your homework. I hope you will do that homework, and let us meet in the next video along with the worksheet, solving of worksheet. I hope you will do, and let's meet in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself and bye-bye.